Thank you. Good afternoon, everybody. Thank you so much for your attention. I think we're almost ready to start. So this is the second of our award ceremonies for today. We're here to honour our TY class, our 5th years and our 6th years, and in a special way, our class of 22 who have returned as special guests this afternoon to be with us. We say a big, big welcome to all our students, parents, staff, members of the Board of Management, and those who are with us on the live stream who couldn't be with us in person today. So we're going to kick things off with a beautiful piece of music from one of our talented 6th years. Rachel Dooley is here to play with us, and we take this opportunity to thank Rachel for all the time you've played for us over the last 6 years. She's a beautiful harpist, and I know you'll enjoy this, so just sit back and relax. Thank you. In the busyness of a school year, we don't often get time to stop. And it's lovely at this time of year to have this opportunity to reflect and to look back and think about all the attainment and all the achievements of everybody in the school community. It brings us back to our intention in the first place. As parents, you decided which school you would send your daughters. And from our point of view, we promised the following in our mission statement. It outlines our purpose and our values, that we would aim to educate the whole person, that we would encourage the qualities of respect and truth, responsibility and happiness. And happiness is an unusual word to find in a mission statement. You don't see it very often, but it is really, really key to learning. If you're not happy, if you're not comfortable, if you don't feel connected and valued, then you don't learn. So it's really, really important to us that you've had a happy time during your years with us, as well as excelling in the different endeavours that you've been involved in. And it's important to us that you felt cared for and included. And it's not always easy. Those buzzwords of inclusion and care are difficult to live day to day. But we do our very, very best to make sure that happens for you. And I hope that's been your experience. So today, as part of this mission statement, we're going to look back and we're going to look at all of the qualities, the wonderful experiences and the achievements of our young people across all aspects of school life. And then we're going to take some time to honour the class of 22. They've been out in the world as Louis Girls, wonderful agents for change, and we're so proud of them. So let's start with the awards for Endeavour. And we're going to ask the year heads to come up and present. I'm going to start first with the 4L class, and Miss Galligan, TY coordinator, is right here. Thank you.
So the nominees from 4L are Grace Carraher, Charlotte Blitz, Caitlin Carroll, Rhiannon Dolan, Rhianna Dullahan, and Paula Beltran. So I'd ask everybody to come up to the stage. Rhiannon. Paula. Paula, Rhianna, Charlotte, and the winner is Charlotte Blitz. Well done, Charlotte. I'll go ahead. 4-0. The nominees from 4-0 are Katie O'Reilly, Sarah Richardson, Eva Sullivan, Aoife McKee. Eva. Sarah. Katie. And the winner is Aoife McKee. From 4U, we have Camelia and Jessica Zhang.
Camelia is not here.
Oh, shit. And the winner is Camelia. And finally, 4I. The nominees from 4I are Marina Godino, Ellie Litchfield, Amy McBride, Jemima Nogbene, and Elizabeth Popa. And the winner is Jemima. Well done.
So congratulations to all our TYs. They've had an amazing experience all year. You might notice that there's a lovely richness in the names because we have 40 nationalities in school and a number of girls from Italy, Spain, France, and Germany and the US who come for TY alone and have a wonderful experience. So thank you to Miss Galligan and the TYs. Can we move on to the fifth year, please? Miss Elaine McGrath is year head and she will introduce the nominees. Thank you.
Hello, everybody. Okay, the nominees for Best Endeavour in 5L, Shamsa Abdullahi. We might wait and just have the applause at the end. Not that she's not worthy of it. Okay. Eva Cotter, Juliana DiFrancesco, Demi Dernan, Shauna Moran, Sarah Mulholland, and Eleonora Zuffi. Okay, and the winner from 5L is Shauna Moran. Okay. Congratulations, girls. Thank you. Okay, and moving on to 5O, and I'll ask Miss Kate O'Byrne to come out to present to 5O. The nominees in 5O, Federica Giorgi, Brianna Keane, and Leah Kennedy. And the winner from 5O, Leah Kennedy. Okay, moving into 5U. The nominees, Carmen Martin, Claire McCord, Rachel McKay, Cody Miles, Megan Riley, and Charlotte Rogers. And Miss McEnany will present. Okay, and the winner from 5U, Megan Riley. Well done. Well done. And one more fifth year group. The nominees for Best Endeavour from 5LCA, Sarah Casey, Rebecca Flynn Kirk, and Charlie Gorman. And Miss Cassidy is going to present. And the winner from 5LCA is Sarah Casey.
Okay, moving on to sixth year, and we have Miss Marie Meehan, the year head for sixth year, to announce the nominees for Endeavour for 6L.
Good afternoon. So we're going to start with the 6L class, and the nominees are Clara Casey, Elizabeth Duff, Nicole Ellis, Shauna Jimenez, Callie McAvoy, Niamh O'Donnell, and Alana Traynor. And the winner for Endeavour in 6L is Clara Casey. Now, we'll move on to 6O, and the nominees are Amy Andrew Hernandez, Claudine Mullahano, Erin Hogan Curtis, Jonah Garcia, and Hafsa Sabri. Okay. And the awards are being handed out, certificates are being handed out by Miss Killorn. Thank you. And the winner from 6O is Amy Andrews Hernandez. Next, we have the 6U class. Our nominees are Aideen Drumgoole, Sarah Dunn, Grace McKernan, Tolu Stephen, and Ellie Sullivan. And Miss Gilmore will give out certificates to the girls. And the winner from 6U is Sarah Dunn. Yeah. And moving on to our 6LCA class, our nominees are Amy Dargan and Caitlin McKeown. And thanks to Miss Trainer, who's giving out the certificates. And the winner in 6LCA is Amy Dargan. Well done. Just look at the camera here. Yeah. Yeah, we got you. Thank you. Now, next we have a little piece of music for you. Sarah Dunn, who is one of our 6 years, is going to play the piano. She has just received an award, so she might be just busy getting photographs down here. But she's going to make her way to the piano. So we'll just give her a moment to get ready. Maybe Miss Kelly, will you give Sarah a little shout there? In case she's paparazzi.
Thank you, Sarah. Thank you so much. So we're moving on to academic excellence. We've talked about the whole person and we've talked about happiness and care, but we also really prize academic excellence. And these awards in each subject are recognizing the students who have worked incredibly hard in their studies and have maintained a high standard of work across their 2 years of senior cycle. We have an award for the top student in each of the subjects, and Miss Meehan will call out the awards for the best student in each of the 16 academic subjects. So we'll ask Miss Meehan to call out the names, and the teachers in each area will present the prizes. Thank you.
So we're starting with academic excellence in Irish, and the winner is Tolu Stephen. Thank you. Next, we have the award for academic excellence in business, and the winner is Jonah Garcia. And Miss Mallon will present the award to Jonah. Well done. Thank you. Now we have the Academic Excellence Award in French. The winner is Callie McAvoy. And thanks to Miss Finnegan for awarding Callie with her award today. Presenting. Next, we have the award for academic excellence in technology goes to Grace McKernan. Thanks to Mr. Nolan for presenting Grace with her award. Next, we have the award for home economics, and the winner is Shauna Jimenez. And thanks to Miss Cassidy for presenting Shauna. Oh, are you okay? Next, we have our award for geography, and the winner is Aaron Hogan Curtis. And thank you to Miss Kelly for presenting Aaron with her award. Our next subject is art, and the winner is Zara Woods. Thank you to Mr. Kilkenny for presenting Zara with her award. Our next subject is Leaving Cert PE. And the winner is Lauren Briscoe. Thanks to Miss O'Byrne for presenting the award. The next award goes to one student, but it's in two subjects. So this student has excelled in both subjects, maths and chemistry. The winner is Hafsa Sabri. Thank you to Ms. Carraher for presenting Hafsa with her awards. Don't look at the camera here. And next we have another student who has awards in two subjects, for history and economics. The winner is Ellie Sullivan. And thank you to Miss Killoran for presenting Ellie with her awards. Very good. Next, we have the student who has won in two subjects, music and Spanish. The winner is Aideen Drumgoole. And thank you to Miss Finnegan for presenting the awards. And next I have a student who has won in three subjects, English, accounting and biology. The winner is Niamh O'Donnell. And thank you to Miss Mallon for presenting Niamh with her awards. Just one at the moment, Brickmore. Great, thank you. Well done to all the sixth years.
So we're moving on from academic towards special awards. These are achievements and attainment over the year that we wanted to recognise. And the first special award goes to two special girls in TY for their student leadership qualities during the year. So we want to recognise Rebecca Myers and Jemima McBenny for all the work that they did. They represented the school at the Lekela Conference in Mullingar, and then they had the bright idea of having a sleepover in the school. And poor Mrs. Dolan didn't get any sleep for the whole night, but it was really worthwhile. So well done, girls. Congratulations.
Hi, the next award goes to two TY students. They displayed great entrepreneurial spirit and creativity, and we really admired their work ethic. They were fabulous at what they did and how they represented the school at the Leo finals. So can I invite Charlotte Belitz and Elizabeth Popup to the stage, please? And thanks to Miss McGrain, who's going to present them with their award. And we wish the girls all the best of luck next year as they go back to France and Germany. And I invite Ms. Pennin to come forward to present the next award.
Brunter in the chassis show, Ergalti, a glock parts the club Guilga, August are in a sorry erupt Leshung Wilga, a Kirk Hunkins of Scotland. The following certificates are awarded to students who took part in the club Guilga and who made a fantastic effort to promote Irish in the school. Cook Argigas Le Irin Drumgul, Demi Dernan, Aoife Geraghty, Brianna Keane, Kalia Kinahan, Charlotte McAleer, Shauna Moran, Sarah Mulholland, Megan Riley, Laura Vernon and Anna Paula Ardner.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm here to present an award to one of our Green School members for her outstanding work. She's been in the Green Schools since she joined our school, and the winner is Joan Garcia. I'd also like to present certificates to the following students: Hamna Chaudhry, Fatima Hassan, Joy James Ayeye, Claudine Mullahano, Iman Shitu, Sherry McDonough, and Zarish Navi.
Our next certificate or award is in recognition of one senior student's contribution to literacy in the school. For the last number of years, there's a competition held in the De La Salle. I don't know if that's the attraction that they go over there, but they go over anyway. It's called the Dragon's Den, and Miss Sheila Borland has been very, very much involved with that. And we recognised it this morning at junior level. We were very privileged and honoured and pleased that this year at junior level we got first and second prize in the competition, and the competition is simply that you choose a book and you be the author of that book and you speak in terms as if you were the author of the book. And at senior level we got second overall prize in competition this year. So in recognition of all of that, one student has stood out for us, and that is Aideen Drumgul.
So the Amber Flag is an initiative to support mental health and create conversation about how we can support ourselves and each other. We're delighted to have been re-awarded our Amber Flag for the third time. This is a collective endeavour, and we are very lucky to have such wonderful proactive students. So I'd like to present this to Jonah Garcia, Tolly Stephen, Kaylee Stewart, Carrie McEnany, and Jessica Smith. I would also like to thank Miss Mee for all her work on this. Thank you.
So I'm here to present the Young Economist of the Year Awards. This is the 10th anniversary of it, so I'm very proud of all my 5th and 6th years who entered it, because the standard was extremely high. So well done to all of you. I'd like to call upon my 5th years now, who won gold and silver medals. So Zara Abdulia, Demi Dernan, Eve Nyenberg, Lucy Morgan Robinson, Erin Gardner, and Ava Cotter. And now my 6th year students, we're very emotional this morning because I'm in my last class with my 6th years. Elizabeth Duff, Amy Andrews Hernandez, Sophia Martinelli, Talani Udekale, forgive me if I did it wrong again, Tolu Stefan, and Ellie Sullivan. And finally, we'd wish to congratulate Ava Cotter, who won a gold medal. Ava's a 5th year. She won a gold medal at the competition this year, but she also won the Central Bank Special Interest Category Award, which is a massive accolade for somebody in 5th year to win. So well done to Ava Cotter. Her project was on the economic impact of inflation and homelessness. And she wins a special commissioned medal from the Central Bank of Ireland, a €100 voucher, and an opportunity to get work experience in the Central Bank of Ireland. So well done to Ava. She also got a medal, so I'll give her to her. Thank you.
So we're moving on to a little bit of music. Now we're going to invite Aideen Drumgoole to play for us. Here she comes. You're singing today, are you? You're playing. She's very multi-talented. It's hard to keep up with some of these young people. Lovely.
Thank you. Thanks very much, Aideen, and thank you also to Aideen, another student in sixth year who has contributed so much to music in our school over the years. Okay, now we're next on to our sports awards. Sport is an integral part of life in St. Louis. I want to commend each and every student who commits to our sports teams and has shown dedication throughout their time here. I especially want to remember today our sixth years. God, I'm emotional. We're going to miss you, and you've shown great commitment to our sports teams throughout the years. And I know COVID didn't help a little bit. There was a little bit of a bump on the road, and it was interrupted for you. But we want to give a big Beulah bus to our sixth-year sports stars. Okay, so we're going to start with the Under-16 Basketball Award. I will explain that we have two awards, an MVP, which is the most valuable player, and an MIP, which is the most improved player. So our MVP for Under-16 Basketball is Paola Beltrán-Ciaz. And our MIP is Rhiannon Dolan. Thanks, girls. Well done. We now move on to Under-19 Basketball, and our MVP goes to Sinead Otto. Well done, Sinead. And now we have our MIP, which goes to Erin Finnegan. Big thank you to Mr. Byrne, who puts a lot of work into our basketballers all over the years. Well done, girls. Our Under-16 award, we have given out the MVP already in the junior awards this morning. So our MIP is a student from TY, and it goes to Molly Kirk. Well done, Molly. Well done. So we move to our senior Gaelic Awards, and our MVP this year goes to Kerry Clinton. Well done, Kerry. Our MIP goes to Sarah Lawrence. Well done, Sarah. We move on to our Senior Soccer Awards, and our MVP award goes to Kira White. And our MIP goes to Kerry Clinton. She's probably backstage still, Kerry. You may come back up again. Well done. big thank you to Mr. Hoy and Ms. Kirk, who look after our soccer teams here in the school too. Okay, then we move to our senior volleyball. And we have one award in this category, and it's our MVP, and it goes to Manpende Gay. Well done, Manpende. And thanks to Miss Spain, who looks after our volleyball players. Well done. And finally, we move to probably one of the most prestigious awards, sports awards in the school. This is given to the person who has demonstrated excellence on the pitch, and they have shown great commitment and dedication to the sports in our school throughout their time in the school to date. This goes to a TY student. It goes to Anya Murray. Well done, Anya. I think we have a musical interlude next with our Search for Star group winners for 2022, Aidan Drumgoole, Sarah Dunn, Zara Woods, Sarah Lawrence and Rachel Dooley. Ella Carey and Nisha Keelan Flynn, two, please. All come forward.
She's gone, there's that odd melody. places I have meant for us to go. Well, some of them we did, most we didn't, and why I just don't know. Slipping through my fingers all the time, I try to capture every minute. The feeling didn't. Slipping through my fingers all the time. Do I really see what's in her mind? Each time I think I'm close to knowing, she keeps on growing. Slipping through my fingers all the time. Sometimes I wish that I could freeze the picture and save it from the funny tricks of time slipping through my fingers. Bag in hand, she leaves home in the early morning, waving goodbye with an absent-minded smile.
So last week we had the privilege of listening to our fifth year students who were interested in a leadership role in the school. And we had about 22 different students who stood and talked to us about their experience in the school, their ideas for improvement, and why they wanted to give back and be a member of the senior council head girl or deputy head girl roles. So after our democratic ballot was accounted for, the following girls have been elected, and we're going to ask the outgoing senior council, that's Jonah, Aideen, Tolu, Erin, Sarah and Amy, to come to the stage. And the ceremony of handover of roles and responsibility to our new head girl, Leah Kennedy, our deputy head girl, Claire McCourt, and to Nandi, Miriam, Shauna and Shamsa, who are going to work with them on the council. Can you all come up here, please? So we'll ask our new senior counsel, new head girl, new deputy head girl, if you'll just stay backstage. We have some work to do straight away. So, and the others can take their seat. And it's no surprise why teachers might get emotional on a day like this, saying goodbye to such amazing, amazing young women that we've watched growing up in front of our eyes. So thank you so, so much to the outgoing senior counsel, and very best wishes to our new counsel who are on duty from now on. That's it. Loads of work for them to do. Thank you very much.
Okay. Next, we want to move on and we want to recognise a number of our students from the class of 2022, which have returned to us this afternoon, and we were just delighted to see them. And they all seem to be in great form, which is great. It's a good start, all right. These girls achieved 500 points or more, and in some cases 600 points or more in Leaving Cert of 2022. So needless to say, they've gone on to great things. And as I say, it's great to see them back and looking so well and just in such great form. So I'm going to call the names now. And if you come up to the stage, we'll do an applause at the end. Kerry Connolly, Katie Cotter, Lana Drumgool, Ife Anyazu, Favour Isiola, Ife Lynch, Aisling Matthews, Ava McEnany, Ellie Mulligan, Aoife Savage, Emma Whitmarsh, and Isabel Wiseman. So congratulations, girls. Sorry, Ciara Roddy, not on the list. My apologies, Ciara, my sincere apologies. I read everything in front of me.
Another special guest. We want to move on to
girls. Please take photographs. I have one more thing from this list. Okay. We want to also recognise one of these girls who was the best Leaving Cert of 2022, and that's Ellie Mulligan. Right. And just sticking with the theme of Leaving Cert 2022, we also just would sort of as a kind of an introduction to the St. Louis Ethos Award, we want to welcome back last year's St. Louis Ethos Award winner, Lauren Boyle. The St. Louis Ethos Award recognizes just that, you know, what it means to be a Louis girl in academic, non-academic, and just generally overall an all-rounder Louis girl, if you like. And it's a great privilege to actually achieve such an award. And while there are often many people worthy of it, only one winner, unfortunately, can happen. But luckily last year, it was for Lauren, as you might say, it was her. Lauren, do you want to say a few words about what you're doing now and how things are going and how well you've got on since you left?
So I'm actually a first year in Ulster University, Coleraine. I left last year and I got the Ethos Award, but I'm absolutely loving university life and I actually miss here so much. Like, I miss the routine and I miss like the crack that we have in the mornings. But honestly, one piece of advice I definitely give to any sixth year or any like upcoming sixth years is just do what you want to do in life and just go for it. If you want to travel, travel. If you want to do like doctor, whatever you want to do, just do it. Because it's so important to follow your dreams and just do what you need to do. But yeah, but good luck to all the sixth years and your Leaving Cert. You'll do amazing.
Lauren, we just got a small token of our appreciation for returning today and just a small little gift, you know, and before you do the handover in a moment.
Yeah.
Thanks so much.
Thanks.
So Lauren is here to present the overall award for Ethos to our winner of 2023. We have three nominees. So as part of all the collation of information before our awards, we asked staff to identify students who embody the St. Louis spirit. And we have three nominees today from the sixth year class. I'm just going to introduce them and then we'll have a chat about them and then we'll announce the winner. Okay. So the first nominee, Aideen Drumgool. I probably don't have to tell you too much about Aideen's talents. As you can see, She's very, very creative in lots and lots of ways and really hardworking as well. What I've written here is Aideen Drum Ghoul, like the Brontes, there were three wonderful drum ghouls of renown. And Aideen is the baby, the last of the drum ghoul girls who came to us in 2017. She's a writer, really creative, and was really closely involved in the TY book to encourage kindness and empathy that she wrote with her friends during the TY year. She's a great promoter of reading, you've seen that. She studies Irish, English, maths, Spanish, music, business. And during this year, we're able to trust her because she's so mature and trustworthy to study her viola so that she can go off to Manchester next year and study viola at a higher level. She's been sound engineer for all our events, Search for a Star, TY Musical. She even, God love her, had to do a disco for the first years of the gym one Christmas. She must have the patience for 10 saints for that gig, but she did it with good grace. She's contributed to Club Gaeilge. She's got loyal friends among her peers, and she's respected and valued. She does certainly embody the values of a Louis girl, and we saw that when she was elected deputy head girl by her teachers and peers. So Aideen Drum Ghoul. The next nominee then, Jonah Garcia. Jonah Garcia joined us in the summer of 2019. Jonah is a force of nature, an exceptional young student. Even in her early days, we recognized her exceptional abilities. She wrote a CBA in her English class about the power of a smile. And it was such a powerful piece that we all watched it over and over again. The power of a smile. Jonah has an amazing smile. It's so true to her. Her smile lights up the room and all around her. She's positivity all the time, always enthusiastic to contribute to school life. She was here before me this morning moving chairs. She's efficient and she's effective. She's exceptionally academic, but she's not arrogant in any way. She's a BT Young Scientist winner. She's heading off to Africa with the BT Young Scientist group in Halloween time as a result of that. She's ambitious and she's driven to succeed, but she does it in such a lovely way. She's an innovator. She communicates really well and she's exceptionally diligent. We saw the work that she did for Green Schools and how she shows empathy and kindness to students, welcoming international students in particular, making sure she finds them out and makes sure they feel welcome and connected. She's head girl in 22-23, only 3 years after joining this school. So Jonah Garcia, like Aideen, represent the school with grace and dignity in all events, and especially at funerals and other difficult times when I've asked them to be with me. So thank you so much for all you've both done, Jonah and Aideen, and we've one more nominee to go. Come on ahead, Jonah. The third nominee, we could be here all day, we've so many wonderful girls, but the third nominee is Sarah Lawrence. We talked about the Drum Ghoul girls. Sarah Lawrence is the eldest of the three fabulous Lawrence sisters. Sounds like a band. Like Aideen, she hails from the Louth Monaghan border. There must be something about Monaghan people. Big wink. Sarah Lawrence is another very hardworking and diligent student, studying biology, chemistry, music, and French. And I see our music teacher, Sister Bernadine, sitting there. I'm sure she's very proud. Over the past 6 years, Sarah has always, always been available to lend a hand to support others, both staff and students. She's shone on the sports teams and in lessons as a mentor, as a helper on corridors for open days and all other events. Sarah has a humble integrity and an inner light that comes from a very caring nature. And in a quiet way, she makes life easier for everyone she meets. She embodies the qualities of respect, truth, and responsibility in her everyday efforts and interactions with people, no matter who they are. And that's why she was elected so often to leadership roles by her peers. In case I painted her as a modern-day saint, she also has an infectious open smile and a beautiful laugh that lights up her face and betrays a bit of mischief and the humor that we all enjoy so much. She has contributed to the life of the school by being so inclusive and caring. And we want you to know how highly regarded you are, Sarah, by all in the school community. Sarah Lawrence. So we'll ask Lauren, to step forward and to hand the award for ETHOS, the most important award in our school, to the winner for 2023. Drum roll. Go. Sarah Lawrence. As we said, all worthy winners, can I ask Jonah and Aideen just to come forward for a small token, something to remember us by. This is a very, very fancy high-tech laptop for college from CTI. So thanks to our friends at CTI. And this is for you, Sarah.
I have nothing prepared. I knew you were going to do this. thanks, Sherry. I can't look at them and I cry. I don't know. I just thanks to everybody. Like, all the girls in school made it so easy to spend 6 years here. And all the teachers, you were all great. And I don't even know why I'm crying. And to Aideen and Jonah, they're both two amazing girls and they're both going to do great things. So well done to them for being nominated as well. But yeah, so well done the class of 23.
So congratulations to Sarah and well done to Jonah and Aideen as well on being nominees. So we've come to the final part of our awards. And at the end of a very jam-packed day, really, I think we're all fairly buzzing at this stage. So it's just a thank you time, really. And again, like I said this morning with regard to the junior awards, the atmosphere has been tremendous. And I think a round of applause for all of the, you know, the nominees and the award winners. So just one more time, just for everybody. Again, they do say that it takes a village to raise a child. I think it takes a whole school community to put on an award ceremony, really, at this stage. So just a few thank yous. I won't itemize the awards committee just yet. I want to leave them just till the end. But again, a lot goes on behind the scenes. And myself and Miss Dolan know that probably more than anybody, really, because the school has to be managed. But, you know, without the help of everybody here, it just couldn't happen. And people are so supportive here. You see it firsthand in the jobs that we're in. And if you don't think you're appreciated, believe me, let me say it now, you're very much appreciated. And that comes from both of us, really. There's just so much, you know, to put something like this on. You know, everybody, including the students, have a role in that. Even your behaviour and your responses in the audience and your encouragement of each other and last year's nominees and last year's students coming back. Everybody really, you know. So just to list through, you know, classroom teachers, you know, our SNAs, our trainee teachers and all our substitute teachers who are obviously manning classes at the moment while this is going on, as they did this morning. All our assistant principals and year heads, Board of Management, of course, of the Sisters of St. Louis, and all your parents as well. I mean, that would, you wouldn't be here without your parents and your guardians and those people at home that get you out during the day and remember those things that you don't remember sometimes. So also our admin staff, our office staff, Ms. Teresa Dullahan, Maureen O'Connell, Sarah Nash, and Nora Riley, and Pamela Bennett, the cleaning staff, and our caretaker, Mr. Jim McCork. So could you just give a round of applause to everybody there, please? And just to the list of the awards committee, as I said this morning,
But I didn't say it to the same audience. Months of work goes into actually preparing an event like this. Not hours or minutes or days or anything like that. It's months, and a lot of the time is their own free time that they give up. So there's a lot of time and energy goes in, and it takes a lot just to get these things running as smoothly as they do. So I mean, the committee, there's 8 members in total. You've seen them around here anyway, moving the various parts of the, you know. So I've Miss Charlene Woods, Miss Sonia McEnany, Mr. Fergal Kilkenny, Miss Anne Marie Kirk, Miss Ashley McGinn, Miss Lorna Brennan, Miss Laura Farrell, and Miss Frances Morgan. So could you just give them all a round of applause, please? And if you could come up to the stage, could we ask you to come up to the stage? We just got some presentations for the committee, please. Could all of you people, I've just called your names out, could you just come up to the stage, please? As many as we have there, please. So this brings us to the end of our proceedings. We have a lovely setup with lights and balloons just around the corner here at the White Doors. If any family members, friends, students want to take photographs before you go home, you're very, very welcome to come in. We also have refreshments in the staff room. We've got tea, coffee, and a few little bits. It is Friday evening. If anybody else would like to stay on, girls, you're so welcome. We hope that you'll stay on and have a little drink with us, and we'll enjoy your company. Can I say a very, very big heartfelt thank you from myself, from Miss Gilmore as well, for all the work that she has done to make all this happen on top of the committee. We're such a busy place, but we absolutely love it. We're delighted to see the end of another happy, successful year. Thank you to so many parents who've come on site today and everybody who's on the live stream as well. Thank you so much. So we'll say goodbye for now, and safe travels home, and thanks a million. Thank you. One there if you want. Bernadine is only 85 today, and we hope to sing happy birthday in the chapel, but you went missing, but they know to do it now, so happy birthday, Bernadine. Thank you.